Today, Rabobank presented its semi-annual results, and we were able to present a net profit of over 1.5 billion euros, which is an improvement by more than 40% in comparison to the 2014 numbers. The results are primarily driven by a significant improvement of cost of related to loan losses. In the last couple of years, these were exceptionally high. And today we have seen that these numbers drop to levels even below the long-term average. We also have seen that the operating results improved further due to a lower operational cost base. But again, the loan losses, these were the main drivers of the improvement of the results. Balance sheet-wise, we see that balance sheet is predominantly flat, a slight increase of our loan book, but that's basically driven by the currency effect and the appreciation of the dollar vis-a-vis the euro. So we expect that also the balance sheet for the forthcoming period will be pretty much flat. The total loan losses amounted to just over 350 million euros. If I split that number into the main segments of the bank, then first of all, in our domestic retail business, the losses were pretty close to zero. And therefore more than 700 million improvement in comparison to last year. That was basically driven by the very strong recovery of the economy. It's all over the place. All economic sectors are performing better than we had expected and also performing better than late last year. Internationally, we have seen a slight increase of loan losses, but still on a relatively low level, still below the long-term average. And our commercial real estate division, of which we announced earlier the year that we are reducing the total exposure, also did show a quite good performance. We were basically able to sell some of our assets at values above book value, which is a very good sign. Capital ratio nowadays is quite a difficult topic. Since we are in the midst of the implementation of CRD4. Late last year, we presented a common equity tier 1 ratio of 13.6%. But since we are in the midst of the phased-in approach, the starting point at the beginning of this year was 13.2%. And also halfway the year, the common equity tier 1 was 13.2%. Of course, we added the results, so the retained earnings were positive. But also our risk-weighted assets increased slightly, and therefore the ratio remained at 13.2. Total capital ratio, which is increasingly, I think, the more important capital ratio, increased further to 21.5%, which is an all-time high for the bank. The liquidity position of the bank continues to be very strong. Both in LCR as well as in NSFR terms, we are well above the minimum requirements of the regulator. And we run a liquidity book of over 80 billion euros at this moment in time. Yeah, there's still a lot of regulatory change to be expected. We are in the midst of the implementation of CRD4 regarding capital, but we are already aware of the fact that there is something like the total loss absorbing capital coming, TLAC. There is a consultative paper which is now called Basel IV on the measurement of the risk-weighted assets, which might have an impact on our books. And that's on top of a multitude of regulation regarding liquidity compliance, etc. So it's clear that the banking industry is changing a lot. Rabobank therefore has to change quite a bit, and that some of these regulations might have an impact on the composition of our balance sheet as well as capital is very likely. The most important part of the balance sheet is our mortgage book. It's a number of over 200 billion of a total balance sheet size of less than 700 billion, so it's a significant part of the balance sheet. Mortgages have performed continuously through the crisis extremely well. The losses peaked at 6 basis points, which is tiny in comparison to any other asset class. And also in the first half of 2015, that very strong performance continued to be the case. What we also see is that the total volume of mortgages and the number which is being presented in the balance sheet is still dropping. Due to the economic and particular interest rate environment we're in, it is attractive for customers to repay on their outstanding debt, and that's basically what they are doing. And the demand for mortgages is clearly increasing, but still not on the levels we have seen before the crisis. Food and Agri, that's another big chunk of our balance sheet, total balance sheet size over 100 billion euros, two-thirds of that is international. Food and Agri has performed strong through the crisis. It's clear that of any economic sector, Food and Agri probably was amongst the best performing, and that also has been the case in the first 6 months of the year. I think the most remarkable one, however, was commercial real estate. Our portfolio is completely domestic. We have also announced that we are actively reducing our total exposure, but it's also pretty clear that the commercial real estate market is showing very strong signs of recovery. And that's also one of the key reasons why we have been able to reduce our total exposure at a positive value, and so selling assets above book value. Rabobank had a funding mandate of 20 billion euros for this calendar year. At this moment we speak, we have done that number more or less. The markets were very willing over the first 7 months, maybe with the exception of the weeks around the Greek discussion. But otherwise, markets were good, were strong, both volume-wise as well as price-wise. So we are more or less done for the year. Rabobank entered into two capital trades in the recent history. The first one was an additional Tier 1 instrument we issued in January of this year, after we got the approval about the tax treatment by the tax authorities, a 1.5 billion euro trade. And more recently, we entered into a Tier 2 in dollars. After a very successful book building, we allocated $2.7 billion, both 10 as well as 30-year bullet. What we are seeing is a very strong recovery of the economy. I think that's a global issue, but particularly in this part of Europe, in the Netherlands, that's clearly the case. So we are very optimistic regarding the development of our loan book, and in particular the loan losses related to that. Maybe the trend in the first half was a little bit over the top, unexpectedly high, but I think trend-wise, that's basically what we are going to face in the next 6 months and afterwards. And so therefore, we are fairly optimistic about the results and the development of the results in the foreseeable future.